Brian Malay, 28, and a resident of Kabawa in Wakiso District, battled against kidney disease for close to 3 years until he underwent a transplant at Medihill Hospital and Fertility Center in Eldoret, Kenya in 2021. Malay shares his story.
These symptoms lasted for almost like, I think it was around 2 years, because I had to travel to UAE, that's where I was working from. And that's when I had to get to know that this thing is getting serious. And the symptoms lasted for almost like 2 years. And the serious symptoms started coming. That's the body swelling, the swelling of the legs, and you get short of urine. Those are the serious symptoms, apart from the blood pressure and the headache. So when those symptoms came in, I had not done any test of the blood sample to get to know that I have that kidney disease. So I was advised to go and see the doctor such that he can check if I have the kidney failure and all that. And the test came out, it was positive. So I was advised to do dialysis.
Malay further explains that the disease caused a lot of stress, fear and anxiety.
Along the way, this thing brings hard challenges whereby you feel stressed because it's really your first time to face such a disease. And you feel you're scared, you lose hope, you start thinking of death and all that. Your pressures are always down, you lose appetite, you don't feel yourself, your body is swelling. And I used to have that thing that they told me I'm going to go for dialysis. It was a big challenge for me because I didn't know anything about dialysis, so I was scared. And
with support from his family and his former employers, Malay embarked on the treatment journey that ended with kidney transplant.
To change my diet, because all that's treatment. You start stop eating some things. If it's the chicken, you don't have to eat the skin. You have to eat fish. Most of the food you're being stopped from. So I started treatment from that side. And dialysis was really expensive, whereby you can't manage it alone. You have to find money, use your savings. You use money from different friends, the company and all that. So they gave me a lot of support.
Kidney disease occurs when the kidneys are damaged and can no longer filter blood the way they should. Malay's case is not isolated. The number of people diagnosed with kidney disease is on the rise. It is the 10th leading cause of death in the world. Sadly, 90% of the people with the disease do not know, and majority of them do not present with symptoms. Once the disease is in advanced stages, an individual may present with the following symptoms.
90% of people who have kidney disease do not know that they have it, and the majority of them do not have symptoms. Once kidney disease is advanced, people might present with the body swelling, they might get pain in the abdomen, especially lower abdominal pain. They might present with lack of appetite, weakness, because kidney disease presents with low blood levels, and they might actually also present with confusion and a few other things. But these are late symptoms. The majority of people with kidney disease actually do not have any symptoms.
The factors that may put you at risk of developing kidney disease are several, as Dr. Kalie Subula explains.
Factors of kidney disease which have been established world over are actually high blood pressure, also known as hypertension, diabetes mellitus, which is high blood sugar, and cardiovascular disease, particularly people who have heart conditions related to the heart and the blood vessels. But in our settings, there are other risk factors like infections like HIV/AIDS, in children, infections like malaria. Those infections do predispose individuals to developing kidney disease.
Children are not spared either. They too develop the disease as a result of urinary tract infections, or they might be born with abnormalities. Hence the need to start preventing the disease among children.
It is very important for us to look at the spectrum of kidney disease from childhood. Parents can actually prevent their children from getting kidney disease. They have to start when they plan to have children, because how long the child takes in the mother's uterus is important. If children are born premature, before 37 weeks of gestation, they are more predisposed to developing kidney disease. Kids who are born small, and kids who get sick often or get malnourished in early childhood, they are also at increased risk of developing kidney disease. Therefore, parents should attend antenatal care regularly to make sure that the children are born well and they are born on at term.
Kidney disease is treatable using about three modalities. However, the outcome depends on the stage at which the disease has been captured.
Yes, kidney disease can be treatable, but of course the treatments are quite expensive. We have about three modalities, and it depends on what stage of kidney disease you come in. If it's early, it can be treated and it can actually be reversed with drugs, drinking, the habits I've just talked above. But once someone gets into kidney failure, they need some kind of support. This will come in form of dialysis, which can be either peritoneal, where water is put in the stomach to remove the toxins, or hemodialysis, where blood is taken into a machine and it gets cleaned. This is quite expensive, needing between 1 million to 3 million shillings a month. The ultimate treatment of kidney failure is actually kidney transplant, and that will cost between 120 and 150 million.
Every second Thursday of March is designated as a global health awareness campaign. The national commemorations were held in Lira City under the theme Kidney Health for All, Advancing Equitable Access to Care and Optimal Medication Practice, which aims at encouraging the public to take care of their kidneys in the best way they can. Kidney disease remains a big problem world over, with a total of 850 million people living with the disease. For Uganda, studies estimate the prevalence of kidney disease in Uganda to stand at 7.8%, which translates into 1 in every 13 battling against the disease. Report compiled by Agnes Chotalengedide for the news.